View from our window. The ledge top with all the little birdie poopies on it. And then up, and we see the parking lot. And then up a little more, and we see all the high rises that are around us. Most of them have businesses down below, and then living quarters upstairs. And the cool thing is, they even have rooftop gardens. Now we're walking into the little bathroom where we're staying. Nice little European style hotel, but one little interesting touch. As we pan into the bathtub area and up, and look, there's the fire extinguisher hose right next to the shower. Just in case there's not enough water coming out of the shower, you can turn on the fire extinguisher. And here's the pile of stuff we're taking on the boat with us. Street scene. This is the street in front of our hotel, sort of Davie Street in Grandview. Busy little street. Bridge to the airport. Taking a picture, unloading our luggage on the underground where we catch the boat. Lots going on. Now we're at the port getting ready to get on the boat. Thank you.
the
It's one of those, what I would consider a very special thing that we get to do, which is to honor our relationships with one another. And what a great place to do that, where we are one family, one big family. And so it's always been such a privilege to officiate these ceremonies for us. Let's see, my credentials are I have a 28-year relationship, so I consider that a great test. And, you know, the thing about all of us to develop relationships and maintain them, it's all about love and commitment and surviving the joys and the disappointments. So it is my hope that you have 20-fold the joys as the disappointments. And so at this time, the whole plan of this event is all about us sharing it together, and to do something this size, one of the things we do each time. And I hope you'll enjoy this, as we'll go around the room and ask each of you to say who you are, how long you've been together, and where you're from. You can say who you are, where you're from, and how long you've been together, okay? And one of you can be chosen to do that between you. It's always interesting to see who gets to speak. and so feel free to, and then after that, we're going to read the vows. And soon after that, Roxana is going to sing for you, and you can feel free to dance. But after we say the vows together, before you dance, there's time for you to say personal, any kind of personal statement or message to each other, or just give each other lots of kisses, okay? And then Rox will play. You can get up and dance if you want to, or just keep kissing. Then after that, we'll have champagne that will be passed out, and we'll have a toast, and then that will end the ceremony, and the cake will be on the atrium six, which is down below one. I've got a prompt over there to just going. Okay, so one floor down in the atrium, we have the cake ready, and so you could have some cake. Any questions?
Just wanna look at you. My heart grew tipsy in me.
We're getting near that time. Where are we in tomorrow? What port is it? Do we know? Ketchikan? Okay, yeah. Ketchikan.
At 5 and 7, we have our welcome receptions. 5 to 5:45 will be the welcome reception for first seating.
So that we can be sure to get the shore excursions off in a timely manner. All right, so just another reminder that tomorrow night we have a fabulous Alaskan barbecue out on deck. That's at 6 o'clock, so be sure to come back to the ship for that. The crew here is preparing an amazing dinner for all of us. So once again, that's at 6 o'clock. Also, tomorrow at 5 p.m. in the Wyang Theater, Meg Christian has graciously offered to do a presentation on Siddha Yoga. So she'll be in the Wyang Theater tomorrow at 5 o'clock, so don't miss that. The Wyang Theater is on deck 7, and it's all the way forward past the shore excursions office. Also, one last announcement I have for the evening. In the program, we did mention that Meg would be doing an artist signing after her second show, and we thought we'd like to give everyone a little bit more time with her. And so we're going to do the signing later this week, where she's just schmoozing, as she said, and signing and spending a little bit more time with all of you. So just so you know, tonight's artist signing will be moved to the end of the week, and just watch your daily program and we'll remind you of when that is as well. So are you ready for the show?
Yeah.
Fantastic. Well, I am going to introduce your MC for the evening. Please put your hands together for our president and founder, Judy DeLugatch.
Yeah. Feeling like I was living on the street with no place to go. And cracked in the cold I was. I felt the cold come through. I was walking around in the pieces. And
talk the other day, because otherwise I would have told you the same story. But she mentioned something that I hadn't heard her mention before, and it just was a great synchronicity that I had decided to do this little medley. I'm kind of into medleys tonight. And
This is a bunch of songs that were mostly by some of our favorite country singers that captured a particular kind of poignancy. All in all, I'd say they demonstrated really exquisitely why we needed the women's movement so badly. And so I want to sing a little medley of them for you because, God bless them, they gave us some great sing-alongs. And so I would like to encourage you to do so if you remember any of these songs. The first one is by Sandy Posey. I don't know if you remember Sandy Posey. She's the one who gave us It's My Party and I'll Cry If I Want To. She also gave us another really good one. So I'll start with that and then I'll move into Loretta and Tammy. And I didn't change a word in these songs. This is kind of the way it was. Makes no difference if you're rich or poor, or if you're smart or dumb. A woman's place in this old world is under some man's thumb. I was born a woman. I was born to be hurt. I was born to be stepped on, lied to, cheated on, and treated like dirt. I was born to be hurt. Hang on there, it's got a happy ending. A woman's got to give and give. Go on, give faith. A woman's got to love and lose. Go on living. I was born a woman. I didn't have no say. When my man finally comes home, he makes me glad it happened that way. For to be his woman, no price is too great to pay. I was born a woman. I'm glad it happened that way. Hard to understand. Some of you who have been on the journey of one day at a time, staying clean and sober, and walking that particular road. And first of all, I have to untangle these wires, so hang on. Going through all the old songs, thinking what I would like to sing this time, and I came up on this one, which actually, well, it's another medley, okay, but the first one is a song that I've always particularly loved. And, you know, when I look back over our past time together, I'm just kind of assuming that you were all there, because, you know, somebody else was there for you, you know, it was a very complex time and full of celebration and full of challenges. And one of the challenges was that as we began to develop what we called women's music, sometimes we didn't agree on what women's music could or should be, and we wanted so much from it that we all wanted it to be what we needed it to be. And what that meant sometimes was that some kinds of music didn't fit into some people's definitions of women's music, instrumental music, for example. And some people didn't feel that love songs fit into women's music. And I actually had I was doing a concert somewhere in the Northwest. I think it was it was picketed actually by a group of women carrying placards saying, "Meg Christian, politics are mush." And I was like, "Mush, mush, yes." Because we firmly believed that the personal was political.
Yeah, right. Yeah.
And that the most radical thing that we could do was to live our lives honestly the way we wanted to live them. And so I wrote this song. So I wrote this song. I wrote it in the early 70s for a woman who is, by that wonderful synchronicity, going to join me to play this song. And let me say first that the second song was co-written by Holly Neer and myself. And this song was written for a woman who was one of the first women that I met in women's music, and had an enormous influence on my musical life, and who the beauty and the strength of her music and her commitment was really a constant source of inspiration for me, and I expect for you too. So I would very much like for you to welcome Margie Adams. Performed together 22 years ago. Now I have to do the toony thing. Oops. I'm having some logistical difficulties up here. Me and one mic stand. And okay.
Who cannot hear
wrote another one of the most beautiful love songs ever, and she's going to sing it for you. 2 days. Okay, let's see what it is. Let's see. Would you like something deep and profound, or light and whimsical? Okay, let's see. Oh my God. You know, I actually practiced that. Hi, Lily. Lily Vincenzo is here now. Lily Vincenzo was in the picture. Stand up, Lily. She was in the first Olivia recording. Good to see you again.
You're
Okay, I'll just do a medley of all those, okay? Actually, I want to do you something recent. And to show the sort of the where I'm at in my life now. A very strange thing happened to me this year. Actually, two very weird things happened to me. I turned 60. And I started bird watching. Now, I don't think those two things are related, but I'm not sure. But it's the strangest thing because I never paid any attention to birds in my life. Why is she talking about birds? You may wonder. Well, this is where I've come to in my life. I'm thinking about birds, so bear with me. You know, I used to really, birds were something that the cat dragged in. And that was all that was the only attention I paid. And then I had this epiphany, and it really was a spiritual experience. So I wrote a song about it, and I really would like to sing it for you. Okay. And you can substitute any other wild creature you like. I just wrote this song last week, okay? It's a magical moment. It's a moment of grace. Well, I have one more for you, and you know, the years have passed. I want to ask if Beth Mumaw is out there. Beth! Did you go to Robert E. Lee Junior High School? Did you know Miss Berger?
And some daisies in the spring. Some suggestive poems for Christmas by Miss Edna Millay. And the lacy, lacy, lacy card for Valentine's Day. She was a big come.
Go to any gym class and you'll be sure to see
1 million girls who stick to teacher like a deep sticks to a tree. A zillion girls who run the errands and who chases all those balls. One girl who may grow up to be the gayest of all. Sing it one more time. She was a
thank you. but it doesn't matter, because I love you anyway. Coming from the rain, coming from the rain. Oh yeah, I'm coming from the rain.
What happened to that blues thing? Shaka come. I got my drum, the rain, and 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 the rain.
Coming from the rain. Oh yeah. Coming from the rain.